Today's video is to guide you on how to select where to live in the United States domestically, what places to choose to have the best chance of winning asylum, what states, which courts are best for winning asylum, and which states are the worst, okay? My name is Marina Shepelsky, and I'm the founding attorney of Shepelsky Law Group, a group of immigration lawyers and experts that work with clients from all over the United States, helping you guys legalize, getting a green card, of becoming a U.S. citizen, of voting, of traveling with a coveted blue U.S. passport. Every year, thousands and thousands of people file for asylum in the United States. Why is asylum important? It helps people who are afraid to return to their home country because they're being persecuted there, abused, mistreated for being a certain nationality, ethnic group, maybe being gay or LGBTQ. They're fighting corruption, they're in political opposition, and for that, either the government refuses to help or cannot help, cannot protect them. So as a result, they're afraid to return. Their fear is reasonable and is based on something that's already happened in the past. In the past, already they were persecuted, or something that's likely to happen if they go back to their country. For example, if it's somebody from Pakistan and the person says he's gay, he's a homosexual, and maybe he got abused in the past, or maybe now that he's lived in the United States for a while, he feels free, he wants to go back home. He knows that even if he never had any abuse in Pakistan in the past, if he returns to Pakistan and he's honest about his sexual orientation, that's his social group, he will be stoned, put in prison, killed, raped, hurt. He will not have a life, period, in his country. That kind of person, that man, is eligible for filing the form I-589 and asking for asylum, for also withholding of removal, also for relief under Convention Against Torture. And the end game here is to get status of asylum holder, asylee. In 1 year, that status allows you to file for a green card. In the last couple of years, more and more asylum cases have started to go to immigration court. Now, all asylum cases start out in the asylum offices based on where you live. Once that's denied, and unfortunately, statistics show about 90%, like 87 to 90% of all cases filed for asylum do get denied. They don't get approved, they get denied. After that denial, the asylum office sends the court to immigration court. At this point, there's 62 immigration courts and about 500 immigration judges, or a little more now, in the United States. And the special organization TRAC has analyzed all the decisions between 2016 to 2021. And I can talk about the statistics from that, those findings with you today, right? The best courts, I'm just gonna get right into it. The best courts, which means you have to live in the area that this court covers. The best courts that grant asylum have more than 50% approval rate on the average. So it's places like New York City that still has judges that approve more than 60%. They also have judges that approve less than like 20%. But if you average it out, your statistical chance of winning in New York City is very high. Along with New York City, we have Arlington, Virginia. We also have Baltimore, which is pretty spread out, but you still have a good chance of winning. We have Boston, less so than maybe our Baltimore, but still it's pretty good. We have Chicago, very good chance of winning there. We have LA, so-so, not the best, but you know, still not terrible. We have San Francisco, that's it, actually, and San Francisco. So I just went over it with you in alphabetical order. Now, the worst, the horrible places to ask for asylum are the states of Texas, state of Florida. Atlanta, Georgia has like almost a zero approval rate. Terrible places like Houston, Texas, Kansas City, Las Vegas, pretty terrible. Miami, that's Florida, bad. New Orleans, bad, Oakdale bad, Omaha bad, Orlando almost zero again. So these are the courts that I just mentioned that your chance of winning is almost zero. So a lot depends on where you're from, your case type, a lot depends on where you live. I recommend you speak to a lawyer when you finalize your case and decide where you will have that final hearing with the court, because where you live definitely makes a difference. I do not recommend anything in Texas. I don't recommend any of the states that are in the South, basically, of the United States. All those states that were for slavery during the Civil War, all the states that are voting against abortion right now, is where you should stay away from if you have an asylum case. I hope this was helpful to you guys. I hope you can use this guidance to make sure you move to a place where you have a great chance of winning. You must have a really good asylum attorney. We can definitely help you. We have a great group here. We are in New York, but we can be with you in any court anywhere in the United States. Thank you for watching. I hope this helps you. Give us a call today. If you have a complicated asylum case, this is one of our greatest winning points. So we can help you win asylum and stay here and get that green card and citizenship. Speak to you later. Bye-bye.